on the show with me today is a couple who have found a way to create a social impact through their crowdfunding platform. Meet Khushbu and Piyush Jain from impactguru.com. Khushbu and Piyush, thank you so much for joining us today. So first of all, I would like to ask you, what was life like before Impact Guru?
Before starting Impact Guru, I was formerly an investment banker at JP Morgan.
Right.
I was working there in New York, Hong Kong and London.
All right, and what about you, Khushbu?
So I was in the luxury goods business. I was marketing some luxury brands back in Singapore, such as Hackett, La Martina, Jimmy Choo, Bath & Body Works.
But tell me, how did the idea of Impact Guru come about? How did you decide to make the jump, especially for somebody like you who is into fashion marketing?
So really, the inception point, if you will, for Impact Guru was when I was a student at Harvard University back in 2011 to 2013. And during this research, I came across new fintech models, with crowdfunding being one of them, which was scaling very rapidly in the US. But in India, we knew that there was a much more of a social requirement, given the immense problems that we have in society. And so we decided to work on that business plan during various courses at Harvard and MIT. And we also got incubated at the Harvard Innovation Lab, which is Harvard Startup Incubator.
I was looking for a new marketing challenge, and what bigger challenge than to scale giving in India.
Right.
So I think it's been a very interesting ride so far.
So where did the initial funding for the venture come from?
So we bootstrapped the venture, obviously with our savings at the beginning. We put all our savings in it. And then we were very lucky that we were able to find Singapore-based VC fund RB Investments.
So have there been any other rounds of funding after that?
Yes, actually recently we raised a Series A round of funding of $2 million, roughly 13 crore rupees. It was led by Apollo Hospitals Group.
How easy or hard was it to convince people to invest in this particular venture, considering that crowdfunding is still something that is new to India?
Let's first demystify what crowdfunding really means. So if someone needed 10 lakh rupees to fund a medical expense, the old way of financing this was to go to five close friends and borrow about 2 lakh rupees each. What we are trying to do now is disrupt this financing method completely through an online technology platform where we make it easy for people to go to social media, Facebook, WhatsApp, and make this appeal for help within their social networks. Mm-hmm. And so the way we encourage funding is, let's say if they go to 200 people and get each person to donate 5,000 rupees each, that's a different way to collect 10 lakh rupees. The advantage this time is you do not even have to repay the money back to those people. And in fact, friends and family are always looking to help each other. And so this concept, as disruptive as it is, was obviously difficult for some investors to understand the scalability. But we were persistent, and through our execution, we got to product market fit. And today we've been able to onboard some really fantastic investors.
So tell me, how does your revenue model work? How do you earn money?
So we need to charge a small fee to be able to sustain our operations. So from all the funds that are raised on the platform, Impact Guru charges a 5% platform fee. And of course, since these are online transactions, so there are some small debit, credit card transactions. So on average, about 91 to 92% of funds raised are received by the patients or the NGOs or individuals who are crowdfunding for various causes on our platform.
So how do you differentiate yourself from the competition then?
Our competition primarily are health insurance and medical lending. And why we believe crowdfunding is a more effective model of financing is, let's say somebody wanted to gather money again for a medical emergency, it's very hard for them to go to a medical lending company and get that amount, because right. If somebody's in a critical stage, people are not very confident about lending money to them, because again, payback is a concern. Crowdfunding, on the other hand, is very innovative in the sense that there's no payback required, like Piyush mentioned earlier. And also in terms of our platform itself, we've been very, very innovative in terms of building something called a story builder that allows people who are not very articulate to frame their own story by simply answering 10 questions. We also have an Android app, which we're in the process of revamping, that allows people to get real-time notifications every time there's a donation and track exactly how their fundraiser is going. So with the help of technology and the model itself, we've managed to do very well compared to, and beat some of our competition off late.
So the storytelling tool is completely automated?
Yes, it's through with the help of artificial intelligence. People can draft their own stories in correct English,
right,
with the right kind of emotions. All they really need to answer is, fact-based questions such as, what disease are you raising funds for? Who are you raising funds for? What amount do you need? All of those questions are answered, and a very, very beautifully drafted story comes
out. Builds a narrative, basically.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Right. Tell me about your success rate. How many campaigns have reached their goal?
So we measure success very differently as a donation crowdfunding platform. And the best statistic is that 70% of the donors who have donated on impactguru.com do not know the individual to whom they are giving money to from before. And that's a true testament to how much trust we have built today on the internet, that so many people are coming forward to do such a noble act, expecting absolutely nothing in return.
Can startups too use Impact Guru as a platform to raise fund?
Yes, startups do use Impact Guru to not raise funds for themselves, but to pre-sell some of their products. So, for example, if somebody makes a donation transacts on a fundraiser started by a startup, they don't necessarily get any equity in return. What they do get is a product that the startup is about to create.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah.
So that's more or less the Kickstarter model.
Yes.
Which
yes.
Is fairly popular in the
There's
US.
No equity involved here.
Right, yeah. Okay. But in case if something like this were to happen, if a startup did approach you to raise funds, you would have to deal with a lot of regulations there, right?
Yes. So crowdfunding is a very regulated activity when it comes to securities crowdfunding. And, the SEBI had come up with a consultation paper around it. So no online technology platform is allowed to sell equity securities online. Even if you talk about P2P lending, the RBI has come up with a very clear framework for how those platforms need to be governed. So I think what we are trying to do is not do securities crowdfunding. We are focused primarily on donations crowdfunding, and to a small extent, some startups come to us for some rewards crowdfunding activities.
But do you see a future in which perhaps crowdfunding platform like yours could be used by startups later on as VCs?
So I think for us, it's very clear that our focus is going to continue to remain to be donation crowdfunding. We do expect regulations to evolve with time. Recently, the US and UK opened up securities crowdfunding online. I think the Indian market is going to take time to mature to that level. But I do not believe crowdfunding in this part of the world can scale so much with regards to securities crowdfunding to replace the kind of capital being pumped in by the VCs.
So what challenges are unique to your industry particularly, which perhaps you would like to inform other entrepreneurs about?
So trust is a very, very important factor. I definitely recommend them to build a product where they take care of all sorts of checks and balances, make sure that transacting on the platform is absolutely safe.
It's very important to have a specific niche that you're able to meet the core requirement of a particular set of customers. So while it is challenging, through grit and determination, anything is possible.
Are there any checks and balances that Impact Guru does for people who come to you to use this platform to get donations?
Let's take an example of a medical fundraiser that's on impactguru.com. So the first thing we do is we verify that case with the hospital and with the doctors to make sure whether that case itself is genuine or not, whether the patient is indeed currently getting treatment or diagnosed at that particular hospital or with that doctor. The second thing we also do is we take a look at all of the documents that they provide. So whether it's whether it be a medical estimation letter or the medical reports or any bills that they might have paid that they're trying to raise funds for. So, and the third thing we do is try and transfer money as far as possible to the bank account of the hospital itself where they're getting treated.
So which campaign is the closest to your heart?
So there is this campaign recently that came to us. There is a lady called Sukanya, Miss Sukanya, who has had some, very, very trying times with regards to health over the past, few years. And her son is a 15-year-old son. She doesn't have a husband anymore. So, and the son obviously doesn't earn. He's still studying. So how does he pay for her, rectal prolapse surgery that she needed to get done recently? She also needed a brain surgery that she had to, that they had to pay for. And so the son, Dikshit, he started a campaign on impactguru.com, and we were able to mobilize more than 15 lakhs in about 3.5 hours. And that's a record on Impact Guru so far. That's the fastest crowdfunding that we've done, in the past these many years.
So how much would you say Impact Guru is worth as of now?
I think as entrepreneurs, what drives us is being able to impact as many lives as possible. That's why we left behind our careers abroad. So I think valuation is definitely not the vanity metric that we are chasing. I think what's important is, how many people are benefiting from our platform. But if we talk about some of our recent traction, we've scaled almost 10 times in the last 12 months. From both a fundraising standpoint as well as a revenue run rate standpoint. This is just the beginning. We expect crowdfunding to grow more than 20 times now in the next 5 years based on data in the US, UK and China.
But the company's broken even?
No, not yet. We expect to break even in the next 12 to 18 months. That's why we raised a Series A round.
So tell me a little bit more about yourselves. What do you like to do in your free time when you're not here working?
What I love doing is I love dancing. I love, going out and eating some great food. I also try and focus on fitness, whatever little time I get. So these are some things I try to do whenever I'm not working.
So I'm a big Real Madrid fan, and I like to travel for various games. Recently, I was in Ukraine for the Champions League final. I also love traveling. This is a hobby we share together. We've traveled to more than 50 countries now. I picked up a new habit recently about watching grandmasters play chess. I find it very intellectually entertaining, if you will, and that keeps me busy during off work hours these days.
That's fascinating. But being a couple who are also business partners, when do you decide that, okay, this is the point that we have to cut off, we are not going to talk about our work, even no conversations over the, over dinner? Does that happen? Is that possible?
That's a great question. We're constantly trying to remind ourselves that, hey, this is, we need to draw that line, we need to switch off, and we need to close all of the work conversations while we're at work. And while we're not perfect at it, we're trying to get better at it.
And also from a work standpoint, she and I are managing completely different teams with very different responsibilities. So that also helps ensure that there are no overlaps in terms of our professional commitments to work.
So what, according to you, is the future of Impact Guru like?
So I think the biggest challenge for scaling crowdfunding in India is increasing the awareness of crowdfunding. And as healthcare seems to be the area that's getting maximum traction, we want to increase the awareness of crowdfunding within the patient community and within the entire healthcare community, whether it is hospitals, doctors, nurses, billing staff, admin staff. And so that's a heavy sales and marketing challenge, if you will, on how to explain this complicated concept to crowdfunding in a very simple manner, right, so that everyone can benefit from it. And the final piece, I would say, is building a fantastic team. We really believe that, for this to go and scale to 20x, 25x over the next 5 years, we need to build a world-class team, which is not just operating out of Mumbai here, but also in various cities all across the country, because the problem of people needing funding is common all across India, not just in tier one cities, but also tier two cities. Mm-hmm. And so that requires a very thoughtful execution plan on how to be able to do that in a sustained manner, monitoring unit economics. So that's what we are trying to do.
Thank you so much, Khushbu and Piyush, for giving us your time.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you so much for having us.